evening, everybody. Is anybody in this auditorium hungry? Thank you for bringing me here. A very special thanks to Saptash Green for coordinating. And we apologize to you for not accepting to come here for a couple of men. Not because I don't want to come out of Madurai. I'm not claiming anything. 500 people there. So attached, so close to the cause. That is the reason I was not able to come a couple of times. But after coming here, I realized that I made a mistake. I should have said yes the first maybe. So in future, I will see that I don't say no to coming here. Just keep all the CNN Hero Award, World Award, Celebrity Awards ready. My intention of playing this video to you is, you know, many of you would have seen this in the YouTube. One thing which makes me happy is, out of 100 countries, 10,000 nominations, Akshaya was being, the organization was being selected, and we were the only one Indian to get the Hollywood Award from the CNN. Representing all of you. Hollywood Awards for the charity was not given to India from 2000, I don't know for what. But 2010, we broke that and we have got the award. It is in Madurai, at Akshaya Trust. Anybody are interested, you can take home. It is yours. Who is this Narayanan Krishnan? He is coming and standing like a buffoon. Who is this guy? Tell you. I did my school, college in Madurai. It was very nice, life full of joy, fun and fantasy. I love cooking, I also love eating. I eat a lot, you know that, you can see. I love to cook food and also eat that. So I happened to get into a catering college, studied well. And in campus interview, I was selected by a 5-star group about there. And I went to Bangalore to work there. I was 19 years at the time. I was working there for about 6 months. And after that, I was supposed to go to Europe on a 4-year bond. Company purchased a hotel there. I was supposed to go. I called up my mom and said, I'm going to Europe. It's a 4-year bond. My mom asked me to come back to my hometown. Said she wants to do a small offering to Goddess Meenakshi, who is our presiding deity. This happened somewhere in 2002. I came back to Madurai. We were all going with the car towards Meenakshi temple. I saw an old man. He was having his own human waste for hunger. Literally, he was having his own stool for hunger. I was literally shocked and freezed for a second. I went to the nearby hotel, brought some to his place, bought a bottle and gave it to him. In 2 seconds, old man ate those peas. Gave me a look of gratitude. His eyes were filled with tears. It was a silent revolution of self-realization which made me think, what am I doing? Star hunger, I feed all my guests. Nobody comes in hunger to eat food there. They just come to grow barley and celebrate functions. I thought in my hometown, there are people who even have a small piece of bread or paratha. I went back to my hotel, one of the incidents. I could not concentrate on my job. I resigned my job. The whatever little savings I had, I came back to my hometown. I had to say and lie to my parents that I'm on a vacation for about 45 days. My friends who went to Europe bought up the landline of my house, and whenever phone comes, my father would only take the call. He took the call. They said, Krishnan did not come. He has resigned. He got frightened. He has not come to Europe. Mom and dad were really worried, and they asked me what happened to him. I said, I'm doing this. Instead of talking to me directly, what happened was they had consulted their friends and relatives to know what exactly is going around with me. Two things were told to them. One, take me to a psychiatrist, put me under medication. Almost 2007, I took a vow that I will not say lie. The truth.
One, take me to a psychiatrist, put me under medication. Second thing is take me to Kerala, Chotanikarai, Bhagavadiyambu temple. Somebody in the family would have done black magic with a milli, sodium, shaving it. Somebody in the family would have done it. So take him to Chotanikarai, nail on the tree or nail him or kill him, do something so that he will become honored, go back to Europe, earn money, spoil the society, so that you all can amass wealth. So I told my mom and dad, I don't think I am a romantic. It appears to me, so please tell me I am rectified. It has become 12 years I am doing this here. If it is going to be a romanticism, it will continue. No harm for the society. So I told my parents that I wanted them to come and see before they decide whether I am romantic or I am into any disorder. My mom and dad came, they saw all these people on the roads. An old woman touched the foot of my mom and she said she is able to eat 3 meals a day is only because of me. So after coming home, my mom said, "Krishnan, you feed all these people, I will feed you till I am alive." This happened when I was 22 years old. So my mother gave me strong energy to do this service. She has fed me enough and enough. I am weighing 85 kilos today. So I slowly started feeding people on roads, and I also need to give them a haircut and clean shave and approach local barbers. Nobody came to do that because the local barbers felt that their hairs were stinking. They don't want to do it, and mentally people seeing the barbers, strangers coming with the knives and scissors, they also got frightened. So to solve this problem, I went to Malaya Saloon for 6 months and learned proper haircutting. And so far, 5,000, 6,000 haircuts I would have done to people on roads. Anybody in the destitute, a mentally destitute or a old person die on the road, I take them in the Maruti Omni van and go into the last rites. Three things became a very big problem in my community. One is touching these people and feeding them. And second thing is giving them haircut. And third thing is cremation of destitute bodies. So far, 1,876 dead bodies, I would have done last rites in my district to our destitutes. The community called me and said, "You are grandson of Venkatramaya, you are great grandson of Krishnaya, you are all Ayyar community, great Ayyar, you are doing all this work, why are you supposed to do it? You are not supposed to do it. Hire people and do it." Why I should not do it? They said, "Being a Brahmin, wearing a sacred thread, you are not supposed to." 2005, I removed the sacred thread, put it to the fire and said, "Now I am a human being, I am not a Brahmin." The society says, human being is not supposed to do it, I am an animal. The society says, animals are not supposed to do it, I am Adam's friend, I am bird. The society says, birds cannot do it, I am your friend, technology, mission robot. It was very nice to see all of you. 2008, CNN and IBN recognized our cause, and they took us to Bombay and they gave Real Hero Award. Lot of awards, showcase full of awards. This media, what they do, one, they take you to Himalayas, or they will put you 1,000 feet down. They never see to that things are balanced. So, awards after awards came, lot of people supported for the cause, the organization grew up well. 2010, the month of April, I received a call. First time I am getting a call from US, 001, some numbers are coming. When I was on my, "Who are you, man? I'm not telling you." I am Anderson, I don't know who he was. 2010. "Whoever you are, this world, I am not bothered. I am cooking, I have to go and feed the people. Call me at 11 o'clock, then only I can talk to you." He called me at 11 o'clock and spoke to me for 2-3 hours. And after that only I realized that this man is Anderson Cooper. I never knew. So they said, "We have to come and see your cause. If we feel that you are doing something good, we want to give you an award." So 2010, all the people from CNN came, auditors came, doctors came, so many processes were going on. So out of 100 countries, 10,000 nominations, Akshaya was being selected in top 100, top 25, top 10, top 2 of the world. Only one Indian to win this award for three reasons. Organization done by the youth, excellent quality of food is being served to the destitute who cannot claim for, and third one is 100% maintenance of accounts. We operate on less than 1% administration cost. Everything goes to the people. A.R. Rahman was being given the award for slum dog millionaire. I got the award for slum god millionaire. That is the award. So because people started supporting from US, Indians who are there, NRIs, they started supporting for the cause. We purchased close to 3.5 acres of land and constructed almost about 75,000 square feet. And now we have housed almost about 500 people inside the campus, mentally people,
old people, Thai institutes are there inside our campus. Madurai district today, I'm proud to say that, is free of destitutes, nobody is there. Out of that, 185 people are very poor in taxes, so please don't forget about the future. Please don't apologize if there are any figure mistakes. 500, I'm pretty sure. 185 people so far we have rehabilitated and we have got them job and they are going for 2,000 to 3,000 rupees monthly salary. Out of that, people who we rescued from the road, whom we rehabilitated, they are donating 200 rupees every month to this cause. Literally. I tried to make some small change in society, starting from 19 years now to almost about 13, 14 years. So trying to do whatever best is in society and slowly, God willing, there are more people to support us, we will expand our service.
Thank you. Jai Hind. Namaste.